वेलकम टू वीलर्न्स ऑनलाइन क्लास ऑफ MCS 012. इन टुडे सेशन वी विल डू द मेमोरी सिस्टम और वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द मेमोरी सिस्टम इन विच द मेजर टॉपिक्स वी विल कवर आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ मेमोरी, मेमोरी हायरार्की, सेकेंडरी मेमोरी एंड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ सेकेंडरी मेमोरी, RAD and its levels, and concept of high-speed memories. Now, first of all, memory hierarchy. Now, firstly, we will discuss the use of memory. Is memory, does any task related to processing? No. Memory is just used for storing the data and information according to the requirement. There are different types of memories available for use. For example, primary memory, secondary memory, virtual memory, cache memory, etc. Now, what is memory hierarchy? Hierarchy means arranging the memory in some sequence or in some form on the basis of the access time and the storage capacity of the memory. Memory is basically required for storage and subsequent retrieval of the instructions and data, and a computer system uses variety of devices for storing these instructions and data, and memory is a very simple system for storing data by using different types of technology. The basic purpose of memory is to provide the fast and uninterrupted access by the processor to the memory such that the processor can operate at the speed it is expected to work. If we talk about the memory hierarchy, then we arrange the memory in different or in a particular sequence. For example, first of all, registers will be there, then cache memory, then main memory, then input-output device, and then magnetic tapes and magnetic disk. Now, if we talk about registers, that comes first in the memory hierarchy. Registers are very expensive. If we talk about the capacity of registers, then the capacity of register is very small. Then if we move further on cache memory, then the capacity of cache memory as compared to registers are a little bit greater. Similarly, the size of main memory is more greater or more than the cache memory, and it means if we move in the memory hierarchy from one memory to another memory, that is from register to cache memory to main memory, and main memory to secondary memory, then the size of memory will increase, the cost of memory will decrease, and the capacity of memory will also increase. So, in memory hierarchy, we arrange the memories, different types of memories, according to the excess time taken and the storage capacity and the cost of the different memories available. Now, two important points are there. The size of memory increases as we move down the hierarchy, and the quantum of data that is transferred between the two consecutive memory layers at a time also increases as we go from a higher to lower side. That is also known as access time. Access time also increases as we go from higher to lower side. Now, the different types of memory such as RAM, ROM, DRAM and flash memory. If we talk about the major categories of memory, then the major categories are primary memory and secondary memory. Primary memory is temporary memory and secondary memory is permanent memory. If we talk about the primary memory, then primary memory is further categorized into two different categories, that is RAM and ROM. RAM is random access memory. It means the data can be accessed randomly from RAM. Secondly, the data or contents of RAM can be read and written by the user. It is normally organized as words of fixed length. RAM is non-volatile memory. RAM is volatile memory. It means it can retain its content as long as the power supply is on. It means if the power supply goes off, then the RAM loses its contents. And each of these memory words has an independent address and each has the same number of bits. RAM is further categorized into different categories like static RAM and dynamic RAM. Static means fixed and dynamic means changeable. If we talk about the dynamic RAM or dynamic random access memory, it is made with cells that stores data as charge on capacitors. It means the dynamic RAM used to refresh it periodically. And static RAM means it retains its contents as long as the power supply is on. And dynamic RAM, even if the power supply is on, but dynamic RAM used to refresh it periodically after some time. The presence and absence of charge on capacitor in case of dynamic RAM is interpreted as binary 1 or 0, and because the capacitors have a natural tendency to discharge, dynamic RAM requires periodic charge refreshing to maintain data storage. Next is ROM. ROM is read-only memory from which we can only read the data. It is essentially a memory or storage device in which fixed set of binary information is stored. And a block diagram of ROM is now you can see the block diagram of ROM in which there are n address line input by the user from which the data to be read and the m output lines. So the capacity of ROM is 2 raised to power n into m. ROM is characterized by the number of words, that is 2 raised to power n, and the number of bits, that is m per word. For example, a 32 into 8 ROM, which can be written as 2 raised to power 5 into 8. 32 can be written as 2 raised to power 5 and 8 can be written as 8, consists of total 32 words of 8 bit each, which means that 8 output lines and 32 distinct words stored in the particular unit. There are only 5 input lines because 32 means 2 raised to power 5. And with 5 binary variables, we can specify 32 addresses. ROM is basically a combinational circuit and can be constructed with the help of different gates. ROM are the memories on which it is not possible to write the data when they are online to the computer. They can only be read as the name clears about the ROM, that is ROM is read only memory. This is the reason why it is called read only memory. ROM is non-volatile, that is data inside the ROM are not lost when the power supply is switched off. ROM is also known as permanent stores. It is basically used for storing the microprograms, system programs, subroutines, and ROMs are non-volatile in nature and need not be loaded in the secondary storage devices. ROMs are further categorized into PROM, that is programmable ROM. PROM was designed, which is also non-volatile and can be written only once, and hence the name programmable ROM. Similarly, PROMs can be written just once. After PROM, EPROMs, that is erasable programmable ROMs, and EEPROM, that is electrically erasable programmable ROMs, are there. EPROMs can be written, read and written electrically, but write operation is not simple. It requires the eraser of whole storage cells by exposing the chip to the ultraviolet light. And in EEPROM are becoming increasingly popular, as in EEPROM the writing time is considerably higher than the reading time. The biggest advantage of EEPROM is that it is non-volatile memory and can be updated easily because it is electrical erasable programmable ROM. But the disadvantage is the high cost, and at present they are not completely non-volatile and write operation takes considerable time. After the ROM, the next type of memory is flash memory. It is another type of semiconductor memory, which is firstly introduced in the mid-1980s, and these memories can be reprogrammed at very high speed, and therefore the name of the memory is flash because they can be reprogrammed at very high speed. This is a type of non-volatile memory, and basically this memory falls in between the EPROM and EEPROMs. In flash memory, the entire memory can be erased in few seconds by using electric erasing technology. And flash memory is used in many input-output devices and storage devices. It is also used to store data and programs, algorithms in cell phones, digital camera, MP3 music players and all. Now, there are two types of flash memories, that is code storage and data storage. Code storage flash is made by Intel and AMD. It stores programming algorithms, and largely it is found in cell phones. And data storage is basically made by SanDisk and Toshiba, and it stores the data and comes in digital cameras and MP3 players. This is all about the primary memory. Now the next is secondary memory. Primary memory has some of the limitations like high cost, limited capacity, volatile. So to remove these advantages, secondary memory is used. The basic advantages of secondary memory is inexpensive as compared to primary memory. Secondary memory has larger capacity as compared to primary memory, and it is non-volatile memory. Now, in secondary memory, first of all, we will discuss the hard disk drive. Now, what is hard disk drive? Hard disk drive contains all the mechanical, electrical and electronic components for holding one or more disk for reading or writing information on it. It means it contains a central shaft on which the disks are mounted, the access arm and read write head, and the motors to rotate the disk and to move the access arms assembly. Now we'll discuss about the magnetic disk. It is a circular platter constructed of non-magnetic material, coated with a magnetizable material, and this is used for storing large amount of data. Traditionally, the substrate has been an aluminium और एल्युमिनियम अलॉय मटेरियल, मोर रिसेंटली ग्लास सबस्ट्रेट्स हैव बीन इंट्रोड्यूस्ड एंड अ ग्लास सबस्ट्रेट हैज अ नंबर ऑफ बेनिफिट्स इंक्लूडिंग इम्प्रूवमेंट इन द यूनिफॉर्मिटी, सिग्निफिकेंट रिडक्शन इन द ओवरऑल सर्फेस टू हेल्प रिड्यूस रीड एंड राइट एरर्स, ability to support lower fly heights, better stiffness to reduce the disc dynamics, greater ability to withstand shock and damage. Next, if we talk about the magnetic read and write mechanism, then the data are recorded on and later retrieved from the disc through a conducted coil named head. In many systems there are two heads, that is one is for reading and one is for writing, that is read head and write head. During a read and write operation, the head is stationary while the platter rotates beneath it. And the write mechanism is based on the fact that electricity flowing through a coil produces a magnetic field. Traditional read mechanism is based on the fact that the magnetic field moving relative to the coil produces an electrical current in the coil. Now, if we talk the data organization and formatting on the disk, then the organization of data on the platter is concentric set of rings called tracks. It means all the disk, before using the disk is firstly formatted. Formatting means the disk is firstly divided into tracks and the tracks are further divided into sectors. That is the concentric set of rings called tracks, and each track is of the same width as the head, and there are thousands of tracks per surface. Tracks are further divided into segments that are called sectors. Adjacent tracks are separated by gaps and data are transferred to and from the disk in sectors. And to identify the sector position, normally there may be starting point of a track and the starting and end point of each sector. Now, if we talk the physical characteristics, then firstly, the head may either be fixed or movable, either respect to the radial direction of the platter. In a fixed head disc, there is one read write head per track. And all of the heads are mounted on a rigid arm that extends across all the tracks, and such systems are rarely available today. And if we talk about the movable head disc, then there is only one read and write head. Again, the head is mounted on an arm, and because the head must be able to position above any track. Next is accessing the disc data. Now, disc operates in semi-random mode of operation and normally are referenced block wise. The disk access time on the disk, the data access time on the disk means the time to access the data from a disk consists of majorly two components, that is seek time and latency time. Seek time means time to reach to a specific track or time to position the head on a specific track. On a fixed head disk, it is a time taken by the electronic circuit to select the required head, while in movable head disk, it is a time required to move the head to a particular track. If we talk about the latency time, then this is a time required by sector to reach below the read-write head. On an average, it is half of the time taken by the rotation, taken for the rotation by the disk. Now, another secondary memories means totally the secondary memories are divided into two major categories, that is magnetic, in which hard disk, we have discussed about hard disk. Next is optical memory, in which CDs, DVDs are there. Now if we talk about the optical memory, then in optical memory CDs and DVDs are there. If we talk about the CD-ROM, that is compact disc ROM, then the information can be retrieved from a CD or CD-ROM by a low power laser housed in an optical disc player or a drive unit. The laser shines through the clear polycarbonates while a motor spins the disc past it. The intensity of the reflected light of the laser changes at it encounters a pit. Specifically, if the laser beam falls on a pit, the light scatters and a low intensity is reflected back to the source, and the area between pits are called lands. Data on the CD-ROM are organized as a sequence of blocks, and typically a block format consists of sync field, which identifies the beginning of the block, header field, it contains the block address and mode byte, data field, which contains the user data, and auxiliary field, which contains the additional user data in mode second. Now the CD-ROM has three advantages. First, larger data and information storage capacity. Second, the optical disk together with information can be stored on it and can be mass replicated inexpensively, unlike a magnetic disk. The optical disk is removable and allowing the disk itself to be used for archival storage. And mostly magnetic disks are non-removable. But there are some disadvantages of CD-ROMs also, that is, it is read-only, it cannot be updated, and it has an access time much longer than that of the magnetic disk drive. Now, there are different variations of CD-ROM, that is compact disk recordable, compact disk rewritable, and DVDs, that is digital versatile disk. If we talk about the compact disk recordable, that is, we can record, it is almost similar to the CD-ROMs. And to accommodate applications in which only one or a small number of copies of a set of data is needed and write once, read many CDs, known as CD recordables. Next is compact disk rewritable. Compact disk rewritable optical disk can be repeatedly written or overwritten as with a magnetic disk. The compact disk rewritables has an advantage over CD-ROMs and CD recordables that it can be rewritten and thus used as a true secondary storage. Next is DVDs, that is digital versatile disk. With the capacious digital versatile disk, the electronic industry has at last found an acceptable replacement for the videotapes used in the video cassettes recorder. DVDs has taken video into the digital age. It delivers movies with expressive picture quality, or it can be randomly accessed like audio CDs. With DVDs, machine can also play. DVDs has huge storage capacity as compared to CDs. Now, next is RAD, that is redundant array of independent disk. It is a multiple disk database scheme and it is termed as RAD, that is redundant array of independent disk. The basic characteristics of RAD is operating system considers the physical disk as a single logical device or drive. Data is distributed across the physical disk, and in case of failure of a disk, the redundant information kept on redundant disk can be used to recover the data. The disk arrays known as RAD system is a mass storage device that uses a set of hard disk and a hard disk drive with a controller mounted in a single box, and all the disk of a disk array form a single large storage unit. The RAD systems were developed to provide the large secondary storage capacity with enhanced performance and reliability, and the performance is basically based on the data transfer rate, which is very high rather than taking the individual disk, and the reliability that can be achieved by two techniques, that is mirroring. The mirroring means the system makes exact copies of the file on two hard disks, and second is stripping, that is a file is partitioned into smaller parts and different parts of the files are stored on different disks. There are various levels of RAD. RAD level 0 is known, can be categorized, RAD from level 0 to level 6 is categorized in different categories, that is 0 is stripping, 1 for mirroring, 2nd for parallel access, 3rd for independent access, 3rd for parallel access, 4th for independent access, 5th again for independent access, and 6th again for independent access with parity and hamming. The basic strategy used in RAD is to replace a large capacity disk drive with multiple smaller capacity disk, and the data on these disks is distributed to allow simultaneous access. Thus, it improves the overall input and output performance. RAD technologies have two important performance considerations, that is data transfer rate and input output request rate, and the high data transfer rate is dependent on the path between the individual disk and memory and fulfillment of the input output request by multiple disk of the disk array. Thus it increase the transfer rate. This is all for today's session. Thank you.